Hi friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Journey with Vijay Kumar Srivastava. Today I am going to present the topic Golden Rice, A New Hope. Before presentation, I would like to introduce myself. I am Vijay Kumar Srivastava. I have completed my MS Agriculture with a specialization in Agronomy from J.B. Pant University of Agriculture and Technology, Pantnagar, and presently working in seed industry as a seed professional in one of the MNC. In this presentation, we have covered the different aspects of Golden Rice, its importance, and its developmental stages. So let's proceed to the presentation. What is golden rice? Golden rice is a new type of rice that contains beta carotene, which is also known as provitamin A, which is converted into vitamin A as needed by the body and gives the grains its golden color. It is developed through genetic engineering and produces two new enzymes that complete the beta carotene expression in the rice grain. Golden rice is a genetically modified, biofortified crop. Biofortification increases the nutritional value in crops. Golden rice is genetically modified in order to produce beta carotene, which is not normally produced in rice. Beta carotene is converted into vitamin A when metabolized by the human body. For the golden rice to make beta carotene, three genes are implanted, two from daffodils and third from a soil bacterium. Here we will discuss the vision of golden rice development. It is to create a good source of vitamin A to public, free of charge for the trade, easily available to them who wants to grow and consume, and an additional intervention to combat vitamin A deficiency. Here we will discuss why golden rice is important to solve vitamin A deficiency. Golden rice has the potential to be a suitable complementary intervention to address vitamin A deficiency, a condition that afflicts 250 million people worldwide. Women and children are the most vulnerable to vitamin A deficiency, the leading cause of childhood blindness and inability of the immune system to combat disease. In Bangladesh, over 20% of preschool and school-age kids are affected with vitamin A deficiency. Multiple approaches are needed to combat vitamin A deficiency, including nutrition education and consuming a diverse and nutrient-rich diet, promoting breastfeeding and complementary feeding practices. Vitamin A capsule supplementation, food fortification, and other public health measures aimed at the control of infectious diseases. The existing approaches have had real success, however, target population are sometimes missed with these interventions, especially in remote areas. Consequently, millions are still suffering from vitamin A deficiency, and golden rice can be an additional tool in the toolbox for addressing this serious public health problem. Research has indicated that one cup of golden rice can provide up to 50% of the daily requirement of an adult for vitamin A. Golden rice was created by transforming rice with two beta carotene biosynthesis genes, which are first one PSY, phytoin synthase from daffodil, Narcissus pseudonarcissus, and second is CRTL, phytoin desaturase, which are extracted from the soil bacterium Erwinia iridivora. Here we will discuss about the research team to whom the credit goes for the development of golden rice. The rice was created by a scientist named Ingo Porticus. It is called golden rice because of its yellow color. Why did this scientist wanted to develop golden rice? The answer is to increase the nutritional value, specifically the vitamin A content of the rice. Since rice is a major staple food of third world countries, the rice was created to benefit the people in these third world countries from helping to decrease the vitamin A deficiency, which causes blindness. The Golden Rice Project, which was begun in early 1990s, was a result of a collaborative efforts between the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology and the University of Freiburg, Germany. Ingo Porticus and Peter Bayer are its main developers. Funding was obtained from ETH Zurich and the European Commission Agriculture Research Program and the Rockefeller Foundation. The other team members are also mentioned here, who played very important role in contributing development of golden rice. In this slide, we will go through the development of golden rice. Here is the diagram which is showing the transfer of the foreign genes into the rice via vectors and the final product, the golden rice. As we had discussed earlier, there are three genes. Two are from daffodils and one gene is from Erewhonia bacteria. And those genes are incorporated in rice grains, which are resulting in the development of golden rice. This rice was genetically modified by using recombinant techniques. The rice of Oryza sativa species of rice had incorporated into its DNA from bacteria and daffodils. In this slide, we will study the step-by-step method how to make golden rice. In first step, the genes that give golden rice its ability to make beta-carotene in its endosperm, the interior of the kernel, comes from daffodils and a bacterium called Erewhonia iridophora. In second step, these genes along with promoters, which are the segments of DNA that activate genes, are inserted into plasmids, which are small loops of DNA that occur inside a species of bacterium known as Agrobacterium tumefaciens. In third step, these agrobacteria are then added to a petri dish containing rice embryos. As they infect the embryos, they also transfer the genes that encode instructions for making beta-carotene. In fourth step, the transgenic rice plant must now be crossed with the strains of rice that are grown locally and are suited to a particular region's climates and growing condition. And the final product will be ultimate golden rice. There were a lot of opposition factors also in the development of golden rice and its acceptance, about which we will discuss here. Since the inception of golden rice in the late 1990s, debates have raged over the transgenic crop, considered as a genetically modified organism GM crop, and it has struggled to gain approval. However, due to significant intervention by environment activities, it is not available for human consumption. Moreover, stringent international regulations such as the Cartagena Protocol have estimated approval of many GM crops. So these are the factors which are delaying the process of approval for the golden rice. Because of lot of oppositions, there were many security checks from which the golden rice has passed and it has been come to the stage of approval. The safety evaluations have shown that golden rice is as safe and nutritious as conventional rice, but comes with the added benefits of increased beta-carotene content in the grain, the Philippine-based IRPI claimed. This nutrient, similar to what is found in orange-colored fruits and vegetables, is converted to vitamin A as needed by the body. This is aimed at covering a vast rice-eating population in the world with high prevalence of deficiencies. The Golden Rice Project has taken about 18 years to reach at this stage. The golden rice can be grown just the same way we grow normal rice. There is no change in cost of cultivation and the agronomy also doesn't change. In fact, it reduces water use by up to 30% without any yield loss. So we can say the golden rice is safe and it can be go for further use, cultivation and approval. Because of its nutritional value, golden rice was one of the seven winners of the 2015 Patents for the Humanity Awards by the United States Patent and Trademark Office. In 2018 came the first approvals of golden rice as food crop in Australia, New Zealand, Canada and the United States of America. The Philippines now join a select group of countries that have affirmed the safety of golden rice. A biosafety application was launched in November 2017 in Bangladesh and is currently undergoing review by Biosafety Core Committee for the development and approval for the cultivation. So now Philippines and Bangladesh are going to join the hands of cultivation approval of golden rice. Golden rice now on the way to closure to reality. Earlier there were a lot of obstacles regarding approvals and acceptance as a food crop, but now as it has been accepted by many countries, and in Asian countries, Philippines is the first country to approve golden rice for direct use, and the Bangladesh will be the next. So now we can say that the golden rice now closer to reality. International Rice Research Institute cultivates the grain fortified with vitamin A in what would be a major breakthrough in agri-food biotechnology, the golden rice is inching closer to reality. The International Rice Research Institute, IRI, and its partners, the Philippines Rice Research Institute and the Bangladesh Rice Research Institute, have successfully cultivated golden rice in controlled environment on IRI campus, and now they are going to approve the cultivation of rice for direct usage. Golden rice is expected to have less shelf life. Scientists believe that there may require some advocacy in case of storage of the rice. The only thing that may require some advocacy is that golden rice should not be stored more than 3 months. It may lose its nutrient after that. Within a period of 3 months, it is enough to provide required nutrients to make a difference to the public health. And beyond that, it starts losing nutritional value. So it will lose its importance. So we have to take care of the storage, that it should be consumed as early as possible. This was all about golden rice. Now my presentation ends here. Thank you very much for your kind attention. See you again shortly. I have given here my YouTube channel details, Journey with Vijay Kumar Srivastava. Having request, please visit the channel, subscribe it, and provide your kind and valuable feedback for further improvement in my next coming presentations. Thank you.